Okay, so now the video you have seen is created by an AI or from a very simple website. Now to create similar videos from your sketches that maybe your child has made a sketch, all you need is just to come to this website, this one, sketch.metademolab.com. And once you're here, you can just click on enter and it will bring you over here. Animated drawings presented by Meta AI Research. Bring children's drawings to life. Okay, whatever drawing you have from your kids, you can bring it to life by animating characters to move around. So this is just a sample. Okay, you don't have to create any account because this is completely free. You can just log in and you can select however you want to animate it, animate your drawings, and it's just going to start just like that. So to start with, you just come down here and say get started, and you have to see that there are four steps that are required for you to animate your images or your sketches. So the first one is upload a drawing of one character wherever the where the arms and legs don't overlap the body. Now see the example below. So this is just a checklist of what you should pay attention to before you upload a given sketch into this platform. So the first thing is make sure the character is drawn on a white piece of paper without lines, wrinkles or tears. Okay, and make sure the drawing is well lit. Okay, to minimize shadows, hold the camera further away and zoom in on the drawing. Don't include any identifiable information, offensive content. Okay, you can check the community standards or drawings that infringe on the copyright of others. So these are just simple things. Now these are sample drawings that you can make use of. For example, feel free to try these demo drawings and clicking on one of the drawings examples below. So these are some examples that they have given. Now let's use one of their examples, and then later on we can use our own by uploading a given image. So all you need is select one of them. Let's say we are going with this one. So the second step after the upload is just to find the character. Is it okay? Is this what you have uploaded? So we've identified the character and put a box around it. Now your own is to just clarify whether it is the character that you've inputted that you have put this box around, which is very correct. Okay, resize the box to ensure it tightly fits one character. Just if it is not fully fitted within the character that you've uploaded, you can resize and go ahead and resize the box to make sure that it fully fits the character that you've uploaded. Okay, so right now in this case it has fully captured this very character that we're after. Now the next thing is you can click on next and it's going to scan through and go to the next step. Okay, so right now it has brought us to this specific position where this is separating the characters from the background. So what we have seen now in step 3 is we've separated the character from the background and highlighted it. So you can see now the character has been highlighted and it's been separated from the background. Now the checklist is if the body parts of your character are not highlighted, use the pen and eraser tool to fix it. So this is the pen and this is the eraser tool. Okay, if you have any issue, you can use the eraser to erase any portion of it, or you can use the pen to correct any portion of it, and then you can vary the diameter of the eraser with these selections. Okay, and you can always reset the mask to the initial one, or you can undo any kind of sketch or anything that you've touched within this particular drawing. Now the next thing is you can check out if the arms or legs are stuck together, use the eraser tool to separate them. So if you find out that the legs or the arms are separated together, you can use this eraser tool to separate the two of them, just like it has been shown here. And in this our case, everything, it looks perfect, and I think the hands and the legs are properly separated, so we can go to the next step, which is the final step, step 4. And in this case, you can now see that this is finding the character joints. It has highlighted all the joints and it has identified the legs, the arms and the rest of the body with just the joint points. So you can see here are your character joints. Here's an example of what it should look like. So it's something like this. Now the checklist is if your character doesn't have any arms, drag the elbows and wrists joints far away from the character and it can still be animated. So if it doesn't have any arms, you can still drag and make it and can still be animated to have an arm. Okay, in the next step, we will use the segmentation mask and these joint locations to animate your character with motion capture data. Okay, so once you're certain of the joint, if you are not certain with any portion of it, you can click and move around to readjust the joint so that you can see it has perfect connection. So once you're certain with this, you can just go ahead and say next to this. And now we have the animation points. You have to just select between the various ones. This is the default one. Okay, right now you can see your image or your sketch is dancing, is moving, is running around because you've selected. Choose one of the animation, the motions below to see your character perform it. So any motion you choose, that's what the character is going to perform. You have a range of them from dancing to funny, jumping to walking. You can select any of them. Let's say this one, fighting, preparing to fight. So let's have a preview. So you can see it very nicely, and I think I kind of like what I am seeing. And at any given point, you can select any. You can go from jumping to dancing to funny things to anything of your choice to walking. Okay, if you wanted to walk, you can still walk. So let me see walking, how it's going to work. Now you can see it working perfectly from sketch, and you can see it is working professionally. Now this is one aspect of it. Let's say we want to try with another drawing. So you can just go ahead, click on drawing to add another one so you can upload directly from here. Okay, navigate to wherever you have your drawings. Assuming I want to import this drawing, I can just select and say open, and it's going to identify this. This is the first step. Okay, I click on next. And you can see we like to help our research. Would you like to help our research? Yes, I agree. And then you can see this is the whole image it has captured. Let's say I don't want this this website to be captured, and I want the image completely captured like that. Okay, and you can see everything is now fit. So you can go to the next. And you can see now this is the separating the character from the background, and it is properly captured. So let's go to the next. Now you can see this is properly, the characters are properly defined, and go to the final stage, which is adding an animation to it, and it's going to start. And you can see right now it is running. Okay, so you can see it is perfectly done. So I think this is just it. If you want to share this video with someone, or this animation with someone, you can come to share like this, and you can copy the link and share with anybody of your choice. So anyone with this link can just play, and you will have a look at the animation you've created. And if there's any bug or any issue, you can always come over here and you can fix it from here, then go to the last stage. Okay, so I think that does it for this tutorial on how to animate your drawings professionally with this website, animating drawings. Okay, I hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching, and I look forward to seeing you in the next one. Bye.